Hello. In this video, we will understand alveolar pressure and intrapleural pressure. First, we will study them separately. Then we will see how they change together during a respiratory cycle. And finally, we will see same changes in a graph. Let's get started. This is a schematic diagram of lungs. This is lung parenchyma. This is airway. And this circle represents alveoli. This is chest wall. The space in between chest wall and lung is pleural space. And take the background as atmosphere. Atmospheric pressure is 0 cm of water. Now let's see alveolar pressure. It is the pressure inside the alveoli. When glottis is open and no air is moving, the pressure in alveoli is equal to atmospheric pressure. That is 0 cm of water. This situation occurs just before inspiration or expiration. During inspiration, the alveolar pressure becomes negative to about minus 1 cm of water. So it draws air from atmosphere. During expiration, it becomes positive, pushing the air out. Now pleural pressure or intrapleural pressure. Needless to say, it is pressure in pleural space. See, lungs have elastic recoil which tends to collapse them. On the other hand, elastic recoil of chest wall tends to expand the thoracic cage. Because of these opposing forces, the pressure inside the pleura is negative. Continuous suction of fluid from pleural space into the lymphatics also contribute to negative intrapleural pressure. Let's add a bit more detail here. Gravity pulls the lungs downwards. As lungs are pulled away from the apex, the vacuum over there increases. And due to pushing of lungs on the base, the vacuum over here decreases. Because of this, intrapleural pressure is more negative near the apex and less negative near the base. After quiet expiration, pressure at the apex is about minus 10 cm of water. At mid-level, it's about minus 5 cm of water. And at the base, it's about minus 2.5. To keep the discussion simple, the pressure is usually considered uniform throughout the height. So this was about pleural pressure. Now let's see how both the pressures change during a respiratory cycle. This is the state just before inspiration. At this point, pleural pressure is about minus 5 cm of water and alveolar pressure is 0 cm of water. Atmospheric pressure is always 0. Now, inspiration starts with expansion of thoracic cage by inspiratory muscles. This makes the pressure in pleura more negative. After inspiration, it's about minus 7.5 cm of water. It also expands lungs. Due to expansion, the pressure in alveoli initially falls to minus 1 cm of water. This vacuum pulls the air from atmosphere. As air enters, the pressure in alveoli increases till it's equal to the atmospheric pressure or 0 cm of water. Thus, at the end of inspiration, the pressure in alveoli comes back to 0 cm of water. Then during expiration, chest wall and lungs collapse. So pleural pressure increases and returns to minus 5 cm of water. The alveolar pressure initially increases to plus 1 cm of water. It pushes the air out of lungs till the pressure balances with atmospheric pressure again. So this was the entire cycle. Please note that in reality, movement of chest wall and lungs occur simultaneously as they are pretty much stuck together. Here I showed them one by one only to explain causal sequence. Now let's see the same events in form of a graph. In this graph, x-axis shows time. This part represents inspiration and this is expiration. On y-axis we have pressure. First let's see pleural pressure. Before inspiration, it's about minus 5 cm of water. As the chest wall expands, it becomes more negative. At the end of inspiration, it's about minus 7.5 cm of water. Then during expiration, it increases and comes back to minus 5 cm of water. Then the cycle is repeated with next inspiration. Now let's see alveolar pressure. At the beginning of inspiration, it's 0 cm of water. Expansion of lungs during inspiration decreases the pressure to about minus 1 cm of water. This results in suction of air from atmosphere till the pressure comes back to the level of 0 cm of water. Then during expiration, collapse of lung increases the pressure to about plus 1 cm of water. This results in expulsion of air and pressure comes back to 0 cm of water again. The cycle keeps repeating. That's it for alveolar and pleural pressure. If you struggle understanding medical concepts, subscribe to channel and also follow me at other social media. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.